Hey, hey, you don't get any bigger than that.
Yeah. So that style not for you, but it's for me.
Greenfield's finest. Boss.
Yeah.
DJ Drama.
Never let a wishbone grow where backbone should. Belly been taking the dash on wood. Stand payments, the back end good. Got sense, but they act no good. So I do the lot of the starstruck. Hop in the ride and we took in the truck, couple in the truck, and they all. They might say what's up when they see me around the city, but really no reason to talk much. Dinner and nice guy, but no nice guys here. I'm toe tagging, no Bilbo baggins, y'all coming up short. Take a recess. This a heat check. Yeah. Shorty, let me quick as a clear with a pre-check. It's lifestyle, not for you, but it's for me. Seen it myself for years. The vision is mine alone. Just me, myself, no peers. Yeah.
That's
I don't
work.
Know who hyping them boys. I'm done giving life for the noise. I give you my life in the source. I don't even write anymore.
Gangsta.
Yeah. Gangsta. Get it in drove like it's whipping a stove. That break hard like habits. No days off, no Sabbath. No snakes in my yard, no rabbits. Never let a wishbone grow where a backbone should. Belly been taking the dash on wood. Stand payment, the back end good. Got sense, but they act no good. Send the same money to Sudan. I could probably take the club for a year or two. Stuck between stunting and a miracle. For real. Let's explore the moment. Ain't outside there agoraphobic. If you see me live, you would know it. Jumping on my do aerobics. Buy a site, P90X. Boss like, we write the checks. Now floss like, we like the flex. Bust down, bust down, bust down. AMG, no bust now. Amiri jeans, SB dunks with a fiends T. No button down. Respectfully, blast for me, you don't f*** out. Round if you wanna. Round if you wanna. It's a lifestyle, not for you, but it's for me. Bossy.
Boss, I'ma go without the ad-libs.
In the booth and I like proof and I don't understand what got enemy. Got a couple of truths that I bust out the roof if I'm ready to ride on my enemy. And you rappers just stole my identity. And I really know why you ain't feeling me. With Tiffany and they restore my agility. And I'm never rehearsing, I'm making them making the verses like Swizzy and Timothy. Never provoke with the go cause I want all the smoke, you can call me a chimney. And I really want, but I settle for, I just ain't a ready to whittle peak. Aim at your head when I kill a beat. Spaghetti and showers like Italy. Never let a wishbone grow where a backbone should. Belly been taking the dash on wood. Stand payment, the back end good. Got sense, but they act no good. Send the same money to Sudan, I could probably keep the hood for a year or two. Stuck between stunting and a miracle. For real.
I know, close your eyes. Think about your wildest dreams. You ready?
And you still couldn't do this.
Gangsta, Green Seal.
Let's go.
I am the first.
You seen the making of a star. They hear my name and remember me.
I am the first.
Just let the record show that I said I'm coming for everything.
I am the first.
You seen the making of a star. They hear my name and remember me.
I am the first of all time.
Said I'm coming for everything. Good, but to be great, you gotta have confidence. The next level was legend. You gotta have accomplishments. In any league, they considering me dominant. The long falls, you know the pit of defeat, bottomless. I was hungry way before I got your support. I hopped off the porch around the time that y'all got awards. Lyrical exercise, this what I call a sport. The fourth bar, brother, but I push the rock off the court. I got champion genetics.
Next
level. One of the best. Remember me.
I am the first.
You seen the making of a star. They hear my name and remember me.
Remember me. I am the first.
Just let the record show that I said I'm coming for everything.
I am the first.
You seen the making of a star. They hear my name and remember me.
Remember me.
Opened back in 2003, have a look at the Link. Lincoln Financial Field, where 70,000 are rocking and ready to go in Philadelphia. Tonight we wrap up an intriguing week two with a good Monday night matchup between the Minnesota Vikings and the Philadelphia Eagles. the final weekend of the summer. Hope you're enjoying it wherever you are as we are off and running on EA Sports. And we will not see a run back on the opening kickoff. This will be a touchback. Throwing right away. He'll get this one complete. That's A.J. Brown. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
The Eagles are 1-0 on the year following the win in week one, and they were able to get that road victory in the opener. Now they look to get to 2-0 in front of the home crowd.
And look, any road win in the NFL, that's huge. But when you do it week one, that gets you pointed in the right direction and sends notice to the rest of the league that you mean business.
And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Philadelphia picking up the first on a gain of 15. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give him the yardage that they needed. But they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
60 Bison. On first and 10, it's Hurts. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. It's Cameron Dantzler who picks it. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. So a big defensive play there on the opening drive, no less, as they make the interception and bring it back for the score.
And I think that's a signal for how this defense wants to play. They want to be disruptive, and you know they're going to take some chances.
Well, sometimes it can burn you, but right there, it paid off. Joseph connects on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Ready. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They start on the ground here at Sanders. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Credit Za'Darius Smith, able to get through and make that tackle for a loss. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out. Because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
Boy, that was certainly well-read defensively. And the key to any screenplay is space to work. And there was none to be found there. And they tackle it for just a short gain.
They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. Off the play fake. Here's Hurts. And this one is incomplete.
That looks like it's going to be 2 empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week in their win. Sometimes you over-game plan, overthink things, get back to what works.
Ready. A great return there of 22 yards. And the Vikings will take over here first and 10. Cook as they begin on the ground. Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there. Touchdown, Vikings! Dalvin Cook, his second rushing touchdown on the year, and the Vikings are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season. But don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. And then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They've been outplayed early, no question, down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. He's going deep for Brown. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Touchdown, Eagles.
There's no doubt that this offense was in desperate need of a quick answer, and they got it. One play, and they're right back in this game.
Because you got the sense if they stalled out here and then another score on the other side to make it a three-score game, could have gotten ugly. Elliott good on the extra point, and that'll make our score 14-7. After the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Vikings now to start their next drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. Cousins. Open here, Adam Thielen. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
Adam Thielen, a terrific wide receiver and synonymous with Minnesota football. You go back to high school, college ball in the state, and now his ninth season with the Minnesota Vikings. 10 touchdown catches last season, makes a nice catch there.
First down, here's the run with Cook. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
Our game here, the Vikings and Eagles, the second of two on this Monday night. The Titans and Bills kicked off a little over an hour ago up in Buffalo. And this, our only Monday night doubleheader of the season, but rumor is might have a few more for 2023.
After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5. Here's Cook again.
And he's going to take this close to the first down marker as he stopped at the Eagles 38. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards, but also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Third and short yardage, Cousins. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
So now they're going to send out the field goal unit to, as they say, fire away from long distance. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And no, it doesn't get there. Hits the crossbar, bounces back out. He had it online, but it comes up about a rotation short. All things considered, a pretty good kick. Just cruel punishment there to be denied by the crossbar.
If you're going to hit from that distance, sometimes you're going to need a little luck. And unfortunately for him, this time the break goes against him.
The Eagles offense sent to begin their next drive.
And CD, you know, sometimes you don't need those complicated game plans or the added wrinkles. Last time, how you think about it, couldn't have been any simpler. One play, one pass. Touchdown.
I know those coaches put a lot of work into this game plan, but I don't think they mind possessions like that at all. They just saved those calls for this possession instead.
Through one quarter, 14-7, our score. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Hurts a handoff to Sanders. Pretty nice aggressive run there before being brought down just inside of the 30. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4. Well, fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts. That's going to be caught. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just did the tip of the ball across the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked out before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down. Scott is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there, and each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
Elliott Good with a PAT, and we are tied at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Taken in at the 3. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And that 14-0 lead to begin the ball game, well, that's gone now. Time to regroup.
I think even up 2 touchdowns, they knew this wasn't going to be a walk in the park, and I think that's why we would see the head coach going up and down the sidelines telling his team, let's stay with it, let's keep going. It's almost like he knew they were going to make their run at him, and they have. As you said, let's see if they can regroup and get going again.
The last
run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Again, it's Cook. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stopped that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Now a third down throw, and it misses the target, incomplete.
Nice call by the defense there on third down. Just flood the field with extra defensive backs in their dime package. Nowhere to go with the football. Forces the incompletion.
Barry on to punt as he gets this one away. Here's Jackson to return. Call that one an even 60 yards, 6-0. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. This Philly offense set to go. They've got momentum on their side. They were once down 14-0. Now it's even at 14 as they look to put together a drive to get them the lead. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle, feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
To throw on second and six. Hurts. Open man. That's Devontae Smith. Devontae Smith. Touchdown. Devontae Smith. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Eagles have taken the lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in big sky country. Any speed limits out there, and off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Take it at about the one. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They'll look for a drive to tie this up, down 21-14 as they have it first and 10. On play action, Cousins. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. N'Kobe Dean brings him down, and that's a play he's going to remember. The first sack of his NFL career.
They just gave up a sack there, and if I'm not mistaken, they gave up four last week, didn't they?
Yes. And just looking really porous, aren't they?
They really are, and I'm wondering if I'm going to have to start thinking about keeping the tight end in, maybe a back, someone to help assist, because right now, the quarterback's been getting hit a lot in the last couple of games.
Throwing on second and long. Cousins. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the gun, here's Cousins. And that is incomplete.
And what did we talk about prior to the game? Their ability to move the chains, pick up first downs. So far, 0-for-3 on third down. If that continues, they'll have little chance of winning this one.
Following the punt return here, there's someone shaken up.
Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment.
Okay, ready?
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. Pass to Brown. He's got it on the crossing route. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Play action. Here's Hurts. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. And what a return as he brings this one all the way back to the 25-yard line.
You've got to know as a quarterback that's going to be tough to outthink this guy in the defensive backfield. He's been at it 11 years now, so he knows all the ins and outs of the position, and he's in the right spot there to come up with the interception.
Cousins gives way to Cook, and he'll manage to pick up about four at second down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. They run it again with Cook. It's a five-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming.
It's not a huge breakaway run, but if your starting running back finishes the game with averages of 5 or 6 yards per touch, you'll take that every single time.
So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. On third and one, here's Cousins. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by James Bradbury. And the Eagles are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line.
Well, I would guess that combined, if you spoke to both defenses, neither side has a lot to celebrate today. They haven't had a lot of stops, but that one right there, that's a big one because they stole points away with that play, and just as importantly, picked up a key stop on an offense.
And that's caught inside the 35. And they'll work this down inside the 30. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half.
Here we go.
So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. Hurts throw taken in by Watkins here. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Quez Watkins, 29 yards. And the Eagles will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. Elliott good on the extra point. And the lead now up to 14. After the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Fields it right around the goal line. A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
90 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in this first half. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a second and 3.
Play action now. Cousins. Blitz coming and down he goes. So we're at halftime here on a Monday night. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Both these teams making their final halftime adjustments. We're just about ready to get back to football. So for the call of the second half, we get back up to Philadelphia and Brandon Guy.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Vikings set to receive the second half kickoff, and they trail it here as we resume play. Taken in at the three. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. By no means, certainly, are they out of this contest. Two-score game start in the third quarter. But you feel like if they don't get points and then they give up points, then it can become a slippery slope. This feels like an important possession.
Yeah, and that slope becomes even more slick if you come away empty-handed on this drive, because then you give them a chance to extend their lead. You need some kind of points here, even if it's just a field goal. It's what I call one of those calming drives, try and slow things down a little bit.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Play fake, Cousins. And complete, right side to Cook. They'll wind up getting just a yard. And third and eight now.
Caught that one from me there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. N'Kobe Dean in there to record the second sack of his young NFL career. Here's Jordan Berry now, standing just outside his own goal line. Here's Jackson. So a change of possession here on the punt. And it will be Eagles football, first and 10. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
60 Eagles! 60 Eagles!
But first down, Hurts. He's going to drop this down to Sanders. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of eight. Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
And so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down. A nice, safe throw and a good one.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Half the 60, half the 60. Kevin Ryan.
On the draw, here's Sanders. And he'll just plow right into a host of tacklers. Nothing there at all, and it'll be second and 10. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Third quarter on a Monday night with a second and 10 coming up. Here's Hurts to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Brown. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 42. That'll put him up over 160 yards receiving now for the game. They can't seem to stop it. From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Hurts. Throw left side complete. That's Sanders. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
They go play action with Hurts. Airing it out deep for Smith. And Hurts is intercepted, his third of the game. And the Vikings force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. And this offense, yeah, they keep running more and more and more, but they kind of got to be careful here, CD. I mean, we're still in the third quarter. This game isn't over yet.
I would agree with you there because while they've had all kinds of success and hit on some deep balls like this, the one thing they can't do is start to get loose with the football. A lot of time left, as you mentioned, and if they keep turning it over, they'll bring them back into the game.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 104 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. They run again on first down. Cook, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Josh Sweat coming in strong and dropping him behind the line of scrimmage.
But these guys are going to chop into that deficit. They got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. Up the middle, it's Cook. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team. Defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
On third down, Cousins. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Anthony Harris. And the Eagles are going to get the football back as time will run out in this third quarter of play. One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Well, Za'Darius Smith there getting in and bringing him to the ground. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Up the middle they go with Sanders. And he is across midfield from 149 to the other 49, a gain of just 2.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Over the middle, complete. It's Watkins. And he's going to be stopped here at the 43, and that is not near enough to pick up the first. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And that's going to bring up a fourth down. Here's Jake Elliott. Career long, by the way, for him, 61 yards. This to make it a 3-score game late. He's got the leg, but it's no good. He missed it right, and this will remain a 2-touchdown game.
Now this one now not over yet, Charles. You've got a sliver of hope on that other sideline.
You certainly do, because that would have made it a three-score game, and that probably would have been curtains at that point. But now if they can get down the field quickly and somehow get the ball back one more time, we may have a different ball game.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. With that last effort, he topples the 5,000-yard mark for his career.
And that doesn't place you among the absolute greats that have ever played the game, but it's a significant achievement and a very, very solid career.
Cousins' throw complete to his receiver, Thielen. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 12 yards there, first down Vikings.
Good yardage on the completion there. And when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. That's number four, sack number four. They had four last week, so he's been down on the ground a lot.
Partner, they say the eye in the sky does not lie. And that's indeed the case, because they watched the game tape from the previous week, incorporated into their own defensive scheme, and continued to get after this quarterback.
And now this defense will be searching for sack number five. After the sack on first down, Cousins, his throw incomplete.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target of the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. Find him. Find him.
Third and long for Cousins. Wilson's got it complete. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. They get 15, but they still needed a little bit more. Fourth down.
Boy, they had a lot of real estate to make up there, but what a big-time play for them. Nice completion, excellent game. Now they're in fourth and manageable.
Just a little short, though, with that marker. Okay, so thought they might go for it here down late. Instead, they trot out the field goal unit. The kick by Joseph is good, and that will get the disadvantage now back down to 11. So that gets them a little closer, but clearly field goals are not going to be enough to win this game, at least not this deep into it.
Yeah, agreed if this were the second quarter, but since we're in the fourth, still two scores down, the question would be, did the field goal do much for you? But we have to admit, from the time we've been calling these games, how fast we've seen teams play, there's still a possibility, right?
Madden moves in a hurry.
Yes, it does.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 47 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning.
After what they faced during this game, where they've given up a ton of yards downfield, that has to be a measure of revenge right there for the secondary. They've been shredded throughout the game and finally forced an incompletion.
It's a second down run with Sanders. And he'll be pretty well stopped in his tracks, give him a yard up to the 42. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first time out. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. Batted by the safety, but caught anyway. The 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Philadelphia. Dallas Goedert. His second touchdown on the season. And the Eagles are on their way to a 2-0 start. Elliott good with a PAT. And the lead is up to 18 now. Now, after
after the touchdown. Here's Elliott on to kick it away. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out, because now it's not a total loss, because as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Cousins to throw it. That's complete to Justin Jefferson. The 40. Pass the 20. Touchdown, Vikings. Justin Jefferson, 78 yards. And the Vikings have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth.
And that touchdown puts us in a position to have a discussion, doesn't it? Now, it'll be a two-score game after the conversion.
Yeah, I mean, there's no doubt with a two-score game, they're going to have to onside kick it. We'll just see if they've got a miracle up their sleeve.
And you wonder what onside kicks they're going to use and in what sequence if they hope to have a chance to win this game.
Joseph connects on the extra point, and that'll make this now an 11-point deficit. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
This taken in at the goal line.
And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And a few kneel downs should come very close to finishing this one off, depending on whether or not we see any defensive timeouts. They still have two, but using them would just be prolonging what's really already been decided. And he'll get this just across the 25-yard line.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Hurts throw there, taken in by Smith. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 16 and an Eagle first down.
With that last completion, CD's now over 400 yards passing in the game, and quite a few of those have come via some pretty big strikes downfield. Certainly not afraid to challenge this secondary, and it's been successful.
I like your observation there, partner, because I agree. This is a group more than capable of torching a secondary any week, as evidenced by their combined stat line here. And in the time we have remaining, wouldn't shock me at all to see them take another deep shot.
Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
Let's go now.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. That one looks like he'll throw here. This is Smith with a grab. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. A big pickup there, without question. That should be more than enough to wrap this one up.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Now whistles and a timeout called here. Not sure of the point of this, but they'll stop it with 4 seconds to go in the game. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. And oh, it'll be intercepted. And the Vikings come up with a late turnover, but it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over.
higher scoring game, Charles, than we typically see in the National Football League. But fun to watch these offenses. They were really clicking. It seemed like everything that they dialed up worked.
Yeah, certainly was.